Whenever we tend to just work for our own self, we are doing kirat just for our own self. We are doing karma, action just for our own self. Knowingly or unknowingly, consciously or unconsciously, we tend to take advantage of the other person's situation. That's the fundamental on which the economy grows. The first lesson when I was in college of economics, the first lesson of business that they taught in the book, I don't remember what book was that now, but it says the fundamental of economic is somebody's gain is somebody's loss, somebody's loss is somebody's gain. Yeah. So when I'm doing the kirat, when I'm doing the action, when I'm doing my karma just for myself, consciously or unconsciously, I'm taking advantage of other person's situation. Right? Bloodsucker, some ways. There's another beautiful story from the, this time from the bag of Nanak Sahib. He is also a great storyteller. There's another phenomenal story. Guru Nanak, as I said earlier, was traveling a lot, one village to another village all the time. He went to a village. There's a carpenter in this village called Lalo. Very poor carpenter. He can barely manage his own 2 square meals. But he's a great devotee lover of Guru Nanak. Lalo hears that Guru Nanak is in town. He goes to Guru Nanak, invites him over for a meal at his house. In the same village, the richest man of the village, the richest businessman of that village, is throwing a great party. He also hears that Guru Nanak ji is in town. He sends somebody to invite Guru Nanak. Guru Nanak doesn't go. He goes to the house of this poor carpenter, Lalo. This rich person who's throwing a grand party, 500 people are invited, you know, 500 different dishes are being made. And then he personally goes because Guru Nanak didn't go earlier when he sent the servant. Now he personally goes. I think his name is Malik or somebody. So Malik himself goes to invite Guru Nanak for the meal at his house. Guru Nanak says, "Sorry, Malik, I cannot come to your house." Malik says, "But why? Why can't you come to my house? I have priests who are chanting the mantras to purify the food that is being prepared. I am getting the water specially from the Ganges so that it's the most sacred water. All the food is being prepared in the Ganges water. Continuously, pandits, the priests are chanting the mantra to purify the food. It's the most pure food, sir. Why don't you come?" Guru Nanak says, "Okay, we shall see." Guru Nanak goes to Malik's house with his companions. And he also asked Lalo, the poor carpenter, to bring roti, the chapati, the bread from his house. The poor bread, without even any butter or ghee or anything, just the bread. Lalo gets his bread to this grand party where now Nanak Sahib is, the Malik's party. There Nanak Sahib asks Malik, "Malik, bring some bread." So Malik also brings the bread which is being cooked in the sacred fire with the mantra chanting, with the Ganges water and all of that. So Guru Nanak takes the bread of poor carpenter in hand, squeezes the bread like this. When he squeezes the bread, milk flows from the bread. Strange. Then he asks Malik to give me your bread. He takes Malik's bread in his hand, squeezes the bread. The blood flows from this bread. He shows to everybody there. He shows to Malik. "Malik, all the wealth that you have generated, all the karma that you have been doing to accumulate this wealth, you've taken a lot of advantage of people. You've not been fair with people. You've kind of sucked their blood to gather wealth for you. knowingly or unknowingly. That's for you to see. But you've done that, Malik. Hence, your bread, there's blood in your bread, blood of people. And in Lalu's bread, there is pure milk which is coming out of it. It's his hard work. It's the purity. We've always connected milk with purity. It's the purity of Lalu's kirat, karma, action. He's so poor, still he's invited me and my fellow travelers. He can only barely afford this bread. Probably he'll go hungry if we eat at his home. He and his wife and his children will go hungry. But he still invited me to offer this simple, poor man's bread. But it is full of love. This is what I call pious, sacred bread, Malik. Not your bread. Your bread is not sacred. What will you do by cooking it in the Ganges water, by cooking it while the mantras are being chanted, when you yourself in your heart, you're not fair to people? Malik understands the message, falls on Guru Nanak's feet, becomes his disciple, changes the way he used to work. That's when Malik starts to learn what is the real meaning of kirat karo, what is the real meaning of performing action. That from now on, Sahib, Nanak Sahib, I will not perform this action just for myself. The benefit of my action will go to everybody. It will be spread out. I will make sure that in my pursuit of wealth, nobody is harmed. I do not take advantage of anybody. Kirat karo. And sir, from today onwards, I offer my karma, my action, my effort to the great universal will. Kirat karo. Such a beautiful thing. So Guru Nanak Sahib is not saying non-doing. Or the masters who've talked about non-doing, this is what they're talking about. Because it is impossible for a human being not to do action, not to act. You will act. Even if you're super rich, you will have to go to kitchen to make food. Or if there are servants to make food, you will have to make the effort to eat the food, to chew the food. That's an effort. You'll have to make an effort to get up from the bed, go to the washroom, act. You will have to do action. To bathe, action. You cannot survive on this earth without action. So some doing you will do. So non-doing is impossible. So when the masters are talking about non-doing, they're not saying non-doing in terms of lethargy or laziness or tamas. For them, non-doing is do not own the fruit of your action. Do not just do it for your self-gain. Expand yourself. Do it as a service. Be the servant of the divine. Are we doing that is the question.